I thought I already had a really fast Dragon 20 team. It turns out I can do it even faster with the build that I'm going to show you guys today. I had to tweak a couple champions for this to work, so we're going to go over a run and their gear. Let's jump right in. A quick reminder before I get started, I will be streaming tonight and we are going to have a gem giveaway. Also, on Game On, I already posted a clip of this run on the phone. So if you want to compare speeds, what it looks like on the phone versus the computer, this is the place to do it. Now, on to today's video, which is basically a follow-up of the previous ones that I've done, all right? So I did the Fire Knight in 35 seconds and then we did the Ice Golem in 37 seconds. So this will be obviously in relation to those because some of the champions are the same. The gear has not changed, all right? So I do want to make that clear, but there are two of them that I literally had to build specifically for this, so let's get right to it. The first champion is obviously Lydia, all right? So she has not changed. Same gear for the Hard Doom Tower, 295 speed, 337 resistance and accuracy is probably the most important part here. But the speed for the dungeons, it's all about the speed and the accuracy. Resistance is not that important. Skills are done. Masteries, here are the ones that I'm using for now, which is obviously Eagle Eye. Maybe one day I will go back to trying to work with War Master. I did say this a couple times before, but I'm not ready to do that. I just don't think, sadly, I have the proper gear to do this. All right, the next champion is our Fancy Seer. She also has not changed. I would love for her to be in a Savage set. I just don't have enough, but I've been trying really hard to farm some Savage gear for the last 3 weeks, which is now I can finally do the Dragon 20 with this speed, all right? So for her speed, 210, 100% crit rate, 261% crit damage, 300 resistance, 336 accuracy. Again, this is for Hard Doom Tower. This is overkill for the dungeons, but you know what? It works anyway, so we're going to keep it that way. And we've got all the skills done. And then for the masteries, same thing here. We do have Eagle Eye for the tier 6. Now, this could be Helm Smasher. Yes, I also said that many times before, but I just don't have the gear to go back to Helm Smasher instead of Eagle Eye. So for the time being, we're going to keep rocking that. So then let's do our Renegade because she's also one of the ones that has not changed. All right, so her speed is 190 roughly. The speeds are really important here if you want to try and replicate this. And we have the accuracy is not that important, although it is pretty good for the Fire Knight because we do get an Evil Eye proc, which is kind of crucial for it to work. So I would say you want to aim for that as well. And we have a shield set. All right, so the shield set is really important here as well. For the skills, they are all done. And then for the masteries, we are using Bulwark. Okay, this is kind of important, especially for the Ice Golem. So I would strongly suggest that if you're going to build your Renegade for the first time, for specifically this, I would, you know, try and replicate this to some extent. And now on to the two new champions that were just recently tweaked for this, and it is two Royal Guards, all right? So you gotta get them in Savage gear. Ideally, it would be like Savage and Crit Damage or Savage and Cruel. It could be random pieces as well, but I think at least one set of Savage is going to be really important, so we're gonna spend a little bit more time on them. They also need to be really slow. As you're going to see in the run, or you already saw basically in the beginning, they don't take turns until the boss itself. Okay, so you really need to understand also what they're going to do with their AI, what they're going to open with, and then how it's going to follow into the rotation of skills. So for this, I would say between 105 and probably maximum 110 speed is where you want to be. The HP is not that important. You might take maybe one or two hits tops if the run really goes sideways, but you should be able to survive with that, all right? So we got 100% crit rate, that is crucial, 232% crit damage, kind of low. I would love for this to be like 250, 260%, but it still works. You could also try and buff up your resistance so that if you do get hit, you would not get all those poison debuffs or something, but that's actually pretty hard to do. You would have to do like a resistance chest and a resistance banner. For the time being, I have accuracy on both of them because this is all I had left on my account. Obviously, you do want crit damage for the amulet. As for the ring, doesn't matter all that much. Refresh accessories would be fantastic, but it is not a must, right? For the chest piece on this one, I have attack percent, crit damage gloves. Yes, these gloves have been moving around quite a bit. And then we have the rest of the pieces, basically crit rate, crit damage. You know what I mean? So just try and get the stats. And we do have slow boots. So defense percent, HP percent would be pretty solid here. Again, you do not want speed. All the skills are done on both of them. And then for the masteries for this one, we have Helm Smasher, We actually have Helm Smasher on both of them, but then we have into the support tree here. Now, I'm probably going to move out of this and go into defense, just to allow them to be a little bit tankier and to hopefully take more than one hit if the run, like I said, really doesn't work out. I might go for Cycle of Revenge or Retribution or both of these. I am still not decided, but for the time being, this is all you really need, all right? So the second one, I just redid the masteries, same as the first one. We still have Helm Smasher, and I'm probably gonna try this out, like I just said, all right? So for the skills on this one, they are also all done. And then here's the gear of the second one. He's a little bit stronger overall. We have 109 speed, again, right on the dot, 100% crit rate, 250% crit damage, which is decent, and accuracy resistance, again, maybe the accuracy is low, but we don't care. As for the individual pieces here, crit rate, crit damage, right? We do have two pieces of crit damage on this one, so this is why his total crit damage is a little bit higher with Helm Smasher. Defense percent for the chest, and we do have HP percent for the boots, so you can kind of see, you can swap these over, it really doesn't matter. And as I said, it could be a resistance chest, all right? Crit damage for the amulet, I still need to get a 6-star on here, and then accuracy banner, all right? So there you have it, guys, that is the team, and I'll quickly show the Great Hall right away in case you guys want to compare stats. Obviously, the only thing that's not done for the Void Affinity is the attack, although it really doesn't matter for that specifically, and then the rest is basically magic for the two Royal Guards. Now let's go check out the run, which is obviously a recorded run, but we're gonna have to pause it just to kind of explain what's going on. As you can see also in the top left corner there, 46 seconds, 40 seconds, and then this one is the fastest one because it was with unlocked FPS, all right? So I'm not always going to run it like this. Pretty simple for the first wave, AoE decrease defense and weaken. I just wanna stop that there for a second and clarify something. If the decrease defense does not land from Lydia, which has a chance of happening because you only have a 97% chance, this will screw your rotation over. You might get lucky where the Royal Guards are going to do their the A3 first instead, and it might still work out, but it could screw up your run. Same thing for the Fire Knight, all right? On the second wave, we're going to reset the skills of Seer and Lydia, and the Royal Guards do not take a turn. So this is really important to understand. At 210 speed for Seer and 110 speed for the two Royal Guards, I still end up being just fine because on Seer, I have the mastery that is going to give her speed when she kills enemy. All right, so she therefore goes above 220, therefore lapping the Royal Guards. That's really important as well because then it is going to matter for here when the skills line up, all right? So we're gonna reset sort of the skills here as well. We do get the A3 from Royal Guards. We're not gonna take a hit because the dragon is going to buff up like that, right? So now we can go into nuking. We do get the extra turn. You don't always get the extra turn. It's not the end of the world. Basically, she would karma burn right there. And right there, boom, boom, that's it, all right? So really simple. We did not take hits on that run, but you can end up taking some hits if, let's say, your Seer goes into nuking while she doesn't have enough buffs. Let's say you get, for whatever reason, you don't have 100% crit rate on your Royal Guards, so that could also affect it. But overall, this is it, guys. So 35 seconds is my fastest run so far with this team right here. Another huge shout out to Deegs, because this is, again, inspired from his team. It's basically the same team, but I just made it work on my account. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you guys later.